Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist, and I'm doing this video because I'm looking for clarity and understanding. And the subject that I'm going to be discussing today is homosexuality, and it came as a result of a video that I did about Antoine. I can't think of his last name, but his name is Antoine something. Anyway, he's decided that he's not going to be homosexual anymore, that he was going to subscribe to the Israelite religion, and that he was going to no longer, practice homosexuality. Now, this is what was said. Now, I received several comments on that video, particularly from Akron. And Akron, I just want to say to you, thank you so much for engaging with me in this conversation, because, like a lot of people, I think I'm about as ignorant as everybody. I have my own assumptions and prejudices when it comes to what homosexuality is, and whether it's an individual or whether it's an act. That's has always been my, misunderstanding, is whether it's an intention or whether it's an act. And basically, I generally always go by the word and what the word means. And so in our exchange, you made me really look at the words that is being used. Now, if we look up the word sexual, and sexual, by the way, is an adjective. And an adjective describes a noun or pronoun, okay? So if your sexual orientation, and orientation is a noun, okay? Your sexual orientation. So the adjective is what, the adjective is what describes the noun. So when we look up the definition of sexual, it's of, relating to, or associated with sex or the sexes, like sexual differentiation, like the difference between a male or a female, or sexual conflict. Okay, when you're having sexual conflicts, or it can mean having or involving sex, the act. Okay, and I think this is where I get confused about it, because that's why, I was saying that I thought that, even though you may be attracted to men as a male or attracted to women as a female, for me, it's the act. Well, then it was the act, but after having a couple of you come forward and say, no, it's not the act, and I guess you're a homosexual, so you would know, because you actually are one and I'm not. So what I got out of that is, you said that sexual orientation refers to gender, when actually sexual, like I said, could mean associated with sex or the sexes, which means male or female, or sex, the act. And orientation is, and I got the definitions, I just looked them up just so I can, have this conversation with you, is that we'll just look at the, because orientation is a noun. So we look up orientation. It's the act or process of orienting or of being oriented, the state of being oriented, or broadly, the arrangement, the alignment, and so forth and so on. And the second part of the definition is a usually general or lasting direction of thought, inclination, or interest. B, a person's self-identification as heterosexual, homosexual, or bisexual. This is what is called a sexual orientation. And see, this is what's so confusing, because using the word sexual, which, again, definition of, relating to, or associated with sex or the sexes, and having it associated with an orientation, which generally means inclination or interest in or something like that, and then turn around and put both of the words together and say that it's a person's self-identification, So is it saying that you're leaning more toward, I'm telling you, this is what really, you know, kind of like confuses me, I think, about the whole situation. Because let me, first of all, I want to say this. I don't think homosexuality is a sin. I could give two shits who people sleep with, okay? I mean, seriously. I don't care. But in the conversation, of course, I got to bring in, you know, what I think I know. But I'm also open to learning. And like I said, Akron, I think you've been very helpful in making me really think about this subject matter. Now, Sir Bonafarts, interesting handle, Sir Bonafarts, said that sex is another word for gender. Homo is Latin for the same. So it says, he says, all it means is you like the same sex, not that you're having sex with someone. So what I did was look up the word sex. It says, one, either of the two major forms of individuals that occur in many species and that are distinguished respectively as female or male, especially on the basis of their reproductive organs and structures. Or number two, the sum of the structural, functional, and behavioral characteristics of organisms that are involved in reproduction, marked by the union of gametes, don't have my little dictionary with me, and that distinguish males and females. So it has to do, according to this, with sexual parts as well, okay? And it also, number three, is sexually motivated phenomena or behavior, okay? And that's why I was saying it was an act, because I'm basically going with the number three, and the B part of that is sexual intercourse, okay? And it also, number four, refers to genitalia, which is your sexual parts. Now, let me see, I was going to try to find my little dictionary here so I could pronounce the word right, but I don't see it. It's G-A-M-E-T-E. I don't have my little speaking dictionary, but anyway, G-A-M-E-T-E-S. The union of gametes and that distinguished male or female. Now, it says that it's not like you're straight until you bang someone with the same sex as you. But then, of course, gametes thought that my onk around my neck was a cross. And he says that he wouldn't expect common sense for someone with a cross around their necks. And I said I wouldn't expect common sense for someone who would confuse an onk with a cross. So we're even, Sir Bonafarts. But I appreciate, but yeah, and he was right, and you were right as well, Sir Bonafarte, when you said that sex is another word for gender. Because what sex in this context does is it distinguishes the male or the female sex according to their genitalia. Okay, what makes a man a man, what makes a woman, their sex is their genitalia, according to this. But also, sex is something that people do. Okay, it's an act. So you have people under the term sexual having or involving sex, you know, doing the cootie, you know, stuff like that. So so if we want to look for definitions of, because see, the English language is filled with words that have dual meanings, and I guess what happens is that we use meanings in different ways. And so for me, if you're, this is what I thought, okay, if you're a homosexual, if you have an attraction, let's say if I had attraction to women, a sexual attraction, which means I want to bang them, okay, to me, that's just an attraction until I actually do it, which then would make me a homosexual, okay? But you guys are saying simply because I'm attracted to them sexually, that makes me a homosexual. And that's where I think I was confused, is because my thoughts were that if you, you know, it's kind of like I gave my example of the murderer. I could sit and think about killing somebody all the time, but I'm not actually a murderer until I actually go and commit a murder, okay? Or I could think about stealing something, but I'm not really a thief until I actually go and steal something, okay? So even though I entertain the idea and I'm attracted to doing it, if I don't do it, then I'm not it. And that's from the context that I was coming from, is that for me, to be in homosexual is that you're active. But I think that Akron came up with some really good examples as far as the homosexual, the person who, and see, another thing is this too, is also what you and I found something here that is your identity, is what you identify as. So if you identify yourself as a homosexual, then you are a homosexual. But if you don't identify yourself, now let's just say, if you don't identify yourself as a homosexual, but you have an attraction, a sexual attraction to men, but you have not acted on the attraction. See, this is where I was coming from. You have not acted on the attraction. So for me, that doesn't make you a homosexual, because first of all, you have not declared that you're one. And secondarily, you have not acted on the attraction, which would, you know, to me, automatically make you one, because now you're into the act of, you know, having sex with someone of the same gender, which is homosexuality under these auspices. So, you know, like I said, I really appreciate, you know, what you're saying. You understand? And like I said, I'm always open to learn something new, because, you know, homosexuality, as far as I've studied, has been around since the beginning of time. Okay, as far back as I could have read about it. And for those who are engaged in it, it's natural for them, as heterosexual or male and woman sex is for me. Okay. And, you know, like I said, I don't have no disagreement one way or the other with whether it's right or wrong, even though I used to, you know, because I was speaking from a biblical standpoint. Now, another thing, I think it was Akron who said this, because, you know, I printed out every damn thing, Akron. But I think you said something to the effect of what's printed in the Bible. And I think I referred you to a couple of scriptures in the Bible, because I have read the Bible. And one of those scriptures was Leviticus 18:22. And you said in your reply that, like I said, I don't think homosexuality is a sin, just like I don't think prostitution is a sin. Anything that's done between two consenting adults, to me, is not a sin, okay? What's a sin is when you perpetrate that on somebody who's not willing. That makes it a sin, okay? Now, I just wanted to go to the scripture that you quoted, and I think we were talking Leviticus 18:22, if I'm not mistaken. And you were saying something to the effect that the correct translation, well, sweetheart, there are like, I pulled up about six translations of Leviticus 18. I'm trying to find your direct statement that you said, because I don't want to misquote you, nor do I want to be misquoted myself. But I want to find that, Akron. Damn it. Oh, God, because my goal is to find the truth. That's my goal. You understand? Oh, here you go. You said that, okay, that's when you were saying homosexuality isn't a sin. But you did say something to the, dang, I don't know what I said, what I do with that comment. But anyway, you were saying in a correct interpretation of that particular scripture. And I want to say that according to the King James Version of the Bible, the 1611 version, which is the original King James Version of the Bible, from what I understand, one of them. Anyway, it says, for Leviticus 18:22, it says, thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is an abomination. It is abomination, not is an abomination. It is abomination. But then you have other translations that says, you shall not lie with one, with a male as one lies with the female. It is an abomination. And that's in the New Standard, the NASV. The New American Standard Version, which came out in 1995. Then in 1901, you had the American Standard Version, which said, thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is an abomination. I think that's the one that you referred to, but it says, and you gotta read it like it says, thou shalt not lie with mankind, comma, as with womankind. It is abomination, okay? Then it says, in the Basic English Bible, it says, you may not have sex relations with men as you do with women. It is a disgusting thing. And then in the Darby Bible, it says, and thou shalt not lie with mankind as one lieth with a woman. It is an abomination. And the Webster's Bible says, thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is abomination. The World English Bible says, you shall not lie with a man as with a woman. That is detestable. And in Young's Literal Bible, it says, and with a male thou dost not lie as one lieth with a woman. Abomination it is. And the Jewish Publication Society Bible, and this is the one that you quoted, says, thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is abomination. So according to the Bible, and various scriptures of the Bible, men lying with men, and they didn't use the term homosexual in that day and time when they were writing those verses and scriptures, but they did specifically say men who lie with men, or you are not to lie with the man as you lay with the woman. Those, according to those scriptures, are supposedly a sin. But as I said, and I think you and I spoke, you referred to one of those scriptures, and you had me go to the beginning of it, where this was God talking to the Israelites coming out of Egypt, I think it was. It was going out or coming in, or one or the other. They were either coming or going. But anyway, he was telling them, don't do those things that they did. So according from what I got out of that is, if they were doing it in Egypt, that's what they did in Egypt, okay? Which is, wasn't a sin in Egypt, okay? But it was a sin according to the Hebrew or the Israelites. I don't know when they became transitioned from Hebrews, from Israelites to Hebrews to Jews. That's a whole nother story. But anyway, these laws were given to the Israelites to follow so that they don't be of the people outside of the Jewish nation or the Israelite nation, okay? And those were given to them. Now, of course, when the New Testament was written and Jesus, the person Jesus came, and then Paul and all the rest of them took this to a religious realm, then it became, the whole text became applicable to the Gentile as well, that they weren't supposed to do these things either. Whereas, you know, prior to there being, put into this, under this umbrella of Christianity, that it was something that they did. I mean, we got historical documents that talks about the Greeks and the Romans and, you know, other areas of the world where people practiced what we call today homosexuality with no second or third thoughts. But most of our adversity to it, for the most part, those of us who aren't homosexual, has to do with the biblical connotations of it, as well as the what we would call the reproductive argument about homosexuality and the fact that homosexuals cannot reproduce between themselves. You know, like two women can't make a baby, two men can't make a baby. So that's the argument with the naturalists, what I would call naturalists, okay, for lack of a better word. And then, of course, you have your religious, okay, who say that it's against the word of God. God said it was wrong, okay? But that, like I said, that applied to a small group of people, not to everybody, until it became part of the religious doctrine that not only was Christian, but also is Muslim, because Islam talks against, excuse me, speaks against homosexuality as well. From what I understand now, like I said, I'm not that well versed on Islam as much as I am on Christianity, but you know, from what my guy says, that it's not allowed, because remember, Islam and Christianity are closely linked to one another, and Islam is really kind of like a offshoot of Christianity, but it was designed for those particular people at those particular times, and because they didn't have a book. So when Muhammad, you know, went up to the mountain or wherever he went, and God told him to recite, and there came the Quran, from what I understand. But anyway, I don't want to get into that because I ain't that versed on that much. But anyway, my point is that, you know, I think that we're too stuck on our own understanding to try to get a clear understanding as to what homosexuality is to those who are. And, you know, because we represent the majority, we think that everything should be according to how we are. And I totally disagree with that. I just think that, you know, I needed more clarity, and I needed to speak, you know, have homosexuals actually come out and talk to me, not dog me out or anything. And I think that's one of the things that there's this, you know, misunderstanding, is that the Christians and the Muslims and all the rest of the people want to put in the naturalists, they want to put their dogma off on people who are oriented, which means what? Inclined, or have interests or thoughts in a certain direction, and their lasting directions of thought, inclination, or interest. So I understand that, you know, people could say that they're born to be homosexual because they've had this attraction since they could remember. So that is a possibility. I used to not believe that. But my other issue was that I thought that you weren't homosexual until you actually engaged in the act. Whereas I think you, Akron in particular, made me really think about the fact that if you have these attractions, you know, now, you know, if you have these attractions, you have these sexual attractions to the opposite sex, I mean, to the same sex, that would automatically make you homosexual. Just like my natural attraction to the opposite sex makes me a heterosexual, whatever hetero is, and I gotta look that shit up too. Heterosexual, and I think those two things are probably something that I want to look into too, is hetero and homo, because I've looked up homo and I know that means man, okay? But hetero, I haven't looked up hetero, so I'm gonna have to look that one up too. And so what was I saying? Damn, I got took off track. But anyway, you know, I think that we, each and every one of us, try to put our own personal thoughts on without really delving into it and really thinking about it. Because at the end of the day, you know, I think a lot of people get homosexuals confused with what you call those, you know, the kind that entice children. Can't think of the word right now. Lord knows it's, I can't think of the word. It's slipping my mind. But, you know, they think that most homosexuals want to have sex with children, and that's not true. As a matter of fact, if you looked at the statistics, you will find that most pedophiles, that's the word, most pedophiles are heterosexual. In other words, they have families and children of their own and things like that. So, you know, you have pedophile homosexuals too. Now let's leave that out, because you have heterosexual pedophiles and you have homosexual pedophiles, okay? So, you know, but what they like to do is say all homosexuals are pedophiles, and they're not. Pedophilia is in its own, in a class by itself, and it encompasses males, females, straight, gays, whatever. They are attracted to children, okay? Period. All right? So, and I think that a lot of times we get those things confused, because we think that the homosexual that work in the school is automatically attracted to your child, when that's not necessarily so. Because I know some homosexuals that have pretty good morals and they would not mess with a child, okay? But you also have the pedophile homosexual. Now, another thing I like to ask is about this, because I'm gonna tell you how the media portrays homosexuals. I mean, in every movie, video, whatever, they portray homosexuals, and this is where I get this thought about sex, is just about sex, is that they portray you in a sexual manner. In other words, they show you promiscuous, they show you focused on sex, that sex is about all it is, when, you know, you could literally have two people that generally love each other of the same sex. But the overall message that we get in the world is that it's always directed at the sexual act, period. Not the love, the sharing, the, you know, sharing your life. It shows you as oversexed, as, what's the word, promiscuous. This is what how the media portrays you. And then, not to mention what you display, what homosexuals display, and not you in particular, any of you that's listening to this video, but what's portrayed in your parades and things like that. I mean, just the blatant sexual activity that's done in a parade out for everybody to see, you know, which for me, sex is private. So I, you know, even strippers and poles and all that other kind of stuff, I have a problem with that, because I think sex is sacred, whether it's between two men, two women, or a man and a woman. I think it's private and I think it's personal. And I think that with the homosexual orientation is that it has taken it and made it, something more, you know, like somebody was at the door. They have taken it and made it more, you know, like open, you know, like your sexual life is just so open. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, you know, it's kind of like if you didn't tell anyone you were gay, no one would know what you were. But for some reason, you have to make a declaration that you're gay. And I guess you do that as a protective measure so that people won't say anything slanderous or anything like that, you know, to, you know, so you forewarn them that, hey, I'm gay, so be careful of what you go say. Because people do make snide remarks about gay people. But anyway, that's, you know, basically what my thoughts on homosexuality. And, you know, not being a homophobe, because I ain't scared of y'all. You understand? I'm open for a dialogue. But I think it's how we're approached, how it's brought to us. And, you know, as a heterosexual, it just seems like your orientation is kind of like shoved down my throat to accept it. You know, now I don't have a problem with it, but for those who are resistant, you know, with resistance come more resistance. So you're like this, right? And so those are going to begin to, you know, refer to their biblical teaching, their naturalist inclinations, you know, to have a rebuttal for you. You understand? And I think that if you just lived your life, and I understand too the fact that, you know, you have to protect yourself, because you do have people that will do something to you simply because you're different. Regardless of whether you're homosexual, black, woman, whatever, you have to have protection in this society. That's just how it goes. But anyway, I think someone wants to get in this room. But, you know, I want to have open dialogue. you know, about homosexuality, you know. And I think, Akron, what you said that was key for me is the fact when you talked about if a man doesn't have sex with a woman, hasn't had sex with a woman or could be a virgin or whatever, does that make him gay? That made me think. Because, yeah, you have gay people who have never had sex with another gay person, with another person of the same sex. And like I said, for me, they wouldn't be gay, okay? But now I understand that from your point of view, it's the attraction that makes you gay, according to you. So I guess we can, I don't know. I think I'm getting more confused as I talk about it. But I kind of see what you're saying, though. I just gotta, you know, because this has all been happening like in the past, 4 hours, I've been really, you know, really thinking about this since, you know, I came to work today. But I want to think about it a little bit more because you made me think about it, you know. And I really, really appreciate what you said as opposed to, you know, condemning me and all that like that other guy did, telling me I didn't have common sense because I had a cross around my neck. Unbelievable. But anyway, I do appreciate you, and I hope that, you know, if I need any more clarity, that you offer that to me, because I don't, you know, I believe everybody can live in the world together. You know, we just have to respect one another. You know, simple as that, and protect one another, you know. So, like I said, I don't have anything against homosexuals and what they do. I don't have anything against heterosexuals. As a matter of fact, I don't have anything against homo sapiens, okay? Let me put it this way. Sometimes I do. I have problems with some homo sapiens, not all homo sapiens, okay? So, anyway, with that, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist. I look for the truth. And if you got a truth, bring it to me so I can assess it to see if I can make it mine, if it makes sense. Because nothing I say is in stone, okay? I don't, you know, say, oh, that's the way it is and that's just how I look at it. You know, everything is up for debate with me because I want the truth. The truth is what I look for, okay? The truth is what I seek in my life, you know? And like I said, there's your truth, there's my truth, and then there's the truth. And the truth is the conclusion where you and I agree. That becomes the truth for me. So with that, unless somebody else comes along with something else, that is debatable. But with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist. And thank each and every one of you for your comments. But I do think that if Antoine decides that he doesn't want to engage in homosexual activity, he won't do it. He won't do it. You know, and he even said himself that he's always been attracted to women. You know, he was attracted to them so much that he wanted to be one. That's what he said, for real. So who knows, sweetheart? You know, maybe there are some homosexuals who are attracted to women. But then they call them bisexuals, don't they? Attracted to men and women, which that's a whole nother story, because if you had your druthers, which one would you be? And whatever one you would be, that's what you are, according to me. So that's another bias. But maybe we could discuss that as well. So with that said, again, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist. And thanks a lot for helping me out. And let's, if necessary, let's continue the discussion. Peace, everybody.